We want to solve the trig equation 3 tangent squared x minus 1 equals 0 on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, where it's closed on 0 and open on 2 pi. So for this equation, we only have one trig function, so let's isolate tangent squared x. So we'll add 1 to both sides of the equation. This will be 0. So we have 3 tangent squared x equals positive 1. And now we'll divide both sides by 3. So we have tangent squared x equals 1/3. And now we want tangent x, not tangent squared x. So we can square root both sides of the equation. We do have to be a little bit careful here. We're going to have tangent x equals plus or minus. This is the same as the square root of 1 over the square root of 3. So we want to determine where tangent x is equal to plus or minus 1 over square root 3. And this ratio should remind you of a 30-60-90 triangle, where the short leg is 1, the hypotenuse is 2, and the longer leg is square root 3. The relationship among the three sides of any 30-60-90 will be multiples of these lengths. So here's our 30-degree angle, and here's our 60-degree angle. And notice how the tangent of 3 degrees is equal to 1 over square root 3. So this tells us that our reference angle, we'll call it theta prime, is equal to 30 degrees. So we can use this reference angle to determine the angles that have a tangent function value of plus or minus 1 over square root 3. And since this function value can be both positive or negative, we're going to sketch a 30-degree reference angle in each quadrant. There's the one in the first quadrant, there's the one in the second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. So because they gave us the interval in radians, we should express the solutions in radians, but it's probably a little bit easier to express them in degrees first, and then radians. So in degrees, we would have x equals 30 degrees, 150 degrees, then we would have 180 plus 30, that's going to be 210 degrees, and then the last angle is going to be 30 degrees shy of 360, or 330 degrees. Okay, so now to express these in radians, our solutions will be x equals 30 degrees is the same as pi over 6. 150 degrees will be pi minus pi over 6, or 5 pi over 6. 210 degrees will be pi plus pi over 6, that'll be 7 pi over 6. And then 330 degrees is 2 pi minus pi over 6, which will be 11 pi over 6. So these are the solutions to our trig equation on the given interval. Now we could also have used the unit circle to determine when the tangent function is equal to plus or minus 1 divided by square root 3, but it's a little bit more challenging than for cosine and sine because tangent theta would be equal to y divided by x. We'd be looking at quotients of fractions to determine where the tangent function was equal to plus or minus 1 over square root 3. So it's always important to be familiar with your reference triangles. Here we have the 30-60-90, and of course there's also the 45-45-90.